Several senior Israeli political and military leaders have spoken out publicly in recent days about the need for a credible military threat against Iran. In the U.S., the Washington Post reported Defense Secretary Leon Panetta believes Israel will strike Iran in April, May, or June. President Obama, however, said he believes Israel hasn't made such a decision. Other international leaders, like UN Secretary General Ban Ki-moon, want a diplomatic solution.
These all pending issues should be resolved peaceful way through dialogue. There is no alternatives to the peaceful resolution of this issue.
We have basically advised strapping on the six-shooter, not pulling the trigger yet.
The advice of former CIA Director James Woolsey is, get ready to use force. How? By moving aircraft carrier groups and planes into position to take on Iran's nuclear program and its Revolutionary Guard. He says financial sanctions against Iran could still bite, but the West needs to speed things up.
They should stop piddling around with this. They ought to get it done and get it done fast, because that will help bring the financial system of Iran down, which is one thing that could help in getting them out of their nuclear weapons program.
But former Israeli Ambassador Yoram Ettinger says there's only one option.
Anybody who wants to stop Iran from becoming nuclear should realize that the only viable option is a military preemption, which is much preferable to risking a nuclear Iran.
Well, Chris Mitchell is now with us from Jerusalem. Chris, the Jews went through the Holocaust. Adolf Hitler is told exactly what he was going to do in Mein Kampf. And he began that program, and people just sat around and said, it can't be happening. We can't believe those peaceful Germans are doing something like that. But they did. So does Netanyahu feel somehow a burden of history on his shoulders now?
I think that's exactly what he feels right now, Pat. I think he feels this sense of history, this burden of history on his shoulders, and also perhaps the future and fate of the Jewish people in his hands. And I think it's not just Netanyahu, but many of the top Israeli leaders are feeling that right now. And I think there's one thing that the Jewish people do over here many times during the year, and that's remember. And two of the main holidays they have is Holocaust Memorial Day, and they have Purim. And Purim happens just next month, and that's when they celebrate deliverance from Haman, a Persian leader who wanted to annihilate the Jewish people. And right now they're taking seriously, Netanyahu and other Israeli leaders are taking seriously, another Persian leader 3,000 years later, Ahmadinejad, who wants to eliminate. And just last week, the Supreme Leader Khomeini said that Israel was a cancerous growth that needs to be wiped off the face of the map. So they are taking this quite seriously and making preparations to take care of Iran.
What specific preparations are they making, do you know?
Well, I think specifically they have a variety of capabilities. And remember, Pat, that they've been doing this for more than a decade. It was 2002 when they discovered that Natanz was enriching uranium. So they had a long time. And this is the number one strategic defense goal of Israel, is to prevent Iran from getting nuclear weapons. And their capabilities include F-15s and F-16s. They have a fleet of those. They have three Dolphin-class submarines. They also have unmanned drones that could fly for up to 48 hours and deliver weapons. And so they have air refueling tankers, in other words, to take those F-15s and F-16s, the 1,000 miles or so it's going to take to reach Iran's nuclear programs. So they've been developing these weapons for a long time. I'm sure they have secret capabilities that no one's aware of right now. But they're set. The policy that I've heard over and over again from officials, from analysts, is that Israel will not allow Iran to get a nuclear weapon. Whether that happens militarily, through sanctions, or a covert war remains to be seen. But their policy is Iran will not get a nuclear device.
The thought is that Iran has not yet hardened their sights, but they have a move to a place near Qom, where there are mountains covering it, so it'd be impossible to bring an airstrike against it. Now, that hasn't happened yet, or is that a particular cutoff point for them?
It is a cutoff point for the Israelis, and Ehud Barak, the defense minister, has called this a zone of immunity. When the centrifuges are moved from Natanz or other places to Qom, and this is called the Fordow facility, they say that it's 220 feet underground. That's two-thirds of a football field. And they say once those centrifuges get down underneath the mountain there, that it would be impervious and immune to a military strike. There's even been talk in the Pentagon. They have this thing called the MOP, which is the Massive Ordnance Penetrator. It's a 30,000-pound bomb that that Leon Panetta said needs more tests, because they're not sure even that could go that far underground and eliminate that nuclear site. But this is the window of opportunity that begins to be closing, and that's the sense of urgency that Israeli leaders are feeling right now.
What's the pushback? You know, with every action is an equal and opposite reaction. What would be the reaction of Iran? Where would they strike Israel? And is there a vulnerability to this?
Oh, there's a big vulnerability, and that's the big debate going on in Israel right now. Is it worth an attack on Iran for the inevitable pushback? That pushback would include the 400 or so Shahab 3 missiles that Iran could fire against Israel. They could alert Hezbollah, that has 50 to 60,000 missiles, to start firing those into Israel. And you know what happened in 2006, Pat, when you were up on the border during the Second Lebanon War, when Hezbollah was firing those missiles. They could close the Strait of Hormuz, or at least try to do that. That could influence the price of oil. But one thing that people need to realize, Pat, is that this is not just an Israeli problem, and this is what I've heard over and over from Israeli officials. It's a regional problem, and it's even a U.S. problem, because Moshe Ayalon, the deputy minister and the former chief of staff of the IDF, said just a few days ago that Iran is developing a 10,000-meter or 6,000-mile missile. And, Pat, that's capable of hitting Virginia Beach. It's capable of hitting New York City or Washington. So this is not just an Israeli problem, but a U.S. problem.
Boy, it's going to be tough. What are the odds? You're not a betting man, but what would the odds be that within the next 3 months they would pull the trigger on this one?
Well, that's what Leon Panetta has said publicly, or at least he's implied publicly, that it could be by June that Israel will strike. Perhaps sometimes in 2012, but it's hard to say here in the Middle East. It's so unpredictable what could or could not happen, Pat, but it seems like Israel is set. The leadership is set. They will not allow Iran to get a nuclear device. And it seems to be that what Iran is doing, what's happening in Israel and the world, is that window of opportunity is closing, and this inevitable confrontation seems to be coming within a matter of months. Whether or not these sanctions will work, and Netanyahu has said recently that they are making Iran wobble a bit, but whether or not that's not going to be enough, I think a lot of people feel, like Yoram Ettinger said in this piece, that it's only going to be a military strike that will stop Iran from getting a nuclear weapon, and it could be in 2012 that that's the year that it happens.
Well, it'll happen before the United States election, because once Obama is reelected, he'll put the screws to Israel and say, no way. But right now, he can't really deal with too much strength about Israel, because the Jewish vote in America is very important, and they don't like Obama. Well, Chris, thank you so much. We'll watch it. It's a scary prospect of a major Middle East war, but that's what looks like it's coming, right?
That's right, Pat. It seems like that's inevitable. It's just it's a question of a lot of people here, not a question of but just when. And could be in a few months, could be in this year. I don't think it's going to go in that much further, but we'll see. We'll see what happens. Certainly a time for a lot of people to be praying for what happens over here in the Middle East.
Amen. Well, we'll pray, and you monitor it for us.